Hello students, how are you all? I hope you are perfectly fine and doing your studies at your home. This is Saumitri Yadav, assistant teacher of Lakshmi Prasad Memorial Public School, which is situated in Gola Bazar, Gorakhpur. I am here with a new video lecture. Firstly, I will remind you once again that in the previous video lecture, we have discussed chapter number 3. And the name of that chapter number 3 is The Aunt and Amabile. But in today's video lecture, we are going to discuss about a poem, and the name of that poem is Our Strange Lingo. Students, firstly, you should know the poet of this poem, and the poet of this poem is Lord Cromer. Lord Cromer is the poet of this poem. So students, in this video lecture, we are discussing about a language which is English. Okay, firstly students, I will tell you the meaning of lingo. The meaning of lingo is a foreign language. Okay, and that particular foreign language is English. Okay, so students, we are going to discuss about English language in this poem. So students, let's start. The poet described English as a very difficult language to read, to write, and to learn. In English language, there are some words which have same rhyming scheme, and also there are some words which have not same rhyming scheme. So, the poet is describing that sound and letters in English language is too much confused. The poet is confused when we speak in English. Most of the words having same spelling, but they pronounce differently. In the poem, the poet is taking too much examples so that are having the same spellings, but they pronunciate differently. The poet is totally confused why the language maker has done these kinds of confusion in English language. Okay, students, this poem is totally based on rhyming scheme. What is a rhyming scheme? राइमिंग स्कीम किसे कहते हैं? राइमिंग स्कीम की का अर्थ है तुकांत शब्द, यानी ऐसे वर्ड, ऐसे दो या दो से अधिक वर्ड जिन्हें बोलने में सेम साउंड आता है, उन्हें राइमिंग स्कीम कहते हैं. राइमिंग वर्ड्स कहा जाता है. ओके, उन्हें राइमिंग वर्ड्स कहा जाता है. ऐसे दो वर्ड्स जिन्हें बोलने पर सेम साउंड, वो सेम साउंड क्रिएट करते हैं, उन्हें राइमिंग वर्ड्स कहा जाता है. इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज में ऐसे बहुत सारे वर्ड्स हैं जिनके जो राइमिंग वर्ड्स हैं. ओके, और लेकिन ऐसे भी बहुत सारे वर्ड्स हैं जिनकी कोई भी राइमिंग नहीं बनती है. और इस पोयम में पोएट ने ऐसे बहुत सारे वर्ड्स का एग्जाम्पल दिया है जिनके लास्ट में जो लेटर्स हैं वो सेम हैं, बट जब हम उन्हें प्रोनाउंसिएट करते हैं, जब हम उन्हें बोलते हैं, तो उनका राइमिंग नहीं बनता है. ओके, विच आर दीज वर्ड्स, वी विल डिस्कस इट इन दिस पोयम. सो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स स्टार्ट फ्रॉम आवर फर्स्ट स्टैंजा. एंड द फर्स्ट स्टैंजा इज, When in the English tongue we speak, why is break not rhymed with freak? Will you tell me why it's true? We say so, but likewise few. Okay, in the first stanza, the poet is saying that when in the English tongue we speak, the poet is saying that when we speak in English, जब हम English language में बोलते हैं, तो why is break not rhymed with freak? तो freak word का rhyming freak word से क्यों नहीं बनता है? Students, you can see E A K letters in both these words. But when we pronunciate these words, the sound of break is ek, break, and the sound of freak is eek, break, freak, break, freak. The rhyming or the sound of these words are not same. Okay, will you tell me why it's true? Kya? Then poet is asking that, ye keh raha hai ki kya aap mujhe ye bata sakte ho ki aisa kyun hai? We say so, but likewise few. Students, we pronunciate as E-W as so, and we pronunciate few as eu. Okay, that the last sound of so is o, and the last sound of few is eu. So these two words are not rhyming words. Okay, now next examples are in the next stanza. And the maker of the verse cannot rhyme his horse with verse. Beard is not the same as horde. Cord is different from word. Okay, in this stanza, the poet has given some more example. Okay, first is cannot rhyme his horse with verse. Okay, students, you can see horse and verse. Okay, when we pronunciate horse, the sound is ors, and when we pronunciate verse, the sound is ers. That's why the rhyming, these two words are not rhyming words. Next one is beard is not the same herd. First one is beard and second one is heard. When we pronunciate beard, the last sound is eared. Okay, when we pronunciate heard, the sound of heard is erred. Students, you can see in the breed word, there are some letters and they are same letters, and we can see in heard there are some few letters. The letters of breed beard and herd are same, but only first letter is changed. But when we pronunciate both these words, they have different sound. Okay, now next one is cow is cow, but low is low. Shoe is never rhymed with four. Think of hose, toes, and loose, and think of goose, and yet we choose. Students, you can see cow is cow, and but low is low. We pronunciate cow, and low as low. But when we pronunciate shoe and four, the sound of these two words are different. This is shoe, this is four, oo and o. The sound is different, so these are not rhyming words. Think of hose. First one is hose, next one is doze, and last one is loose. All the pronunciation of these three words are different. Think of goes and choose. Goes and choose are also different in pronunciation. Now next one is, think of com, tom and bomb, doll and roll, or home and some. Since pay is rhymed with say, why not paid with said, I pray? Okay students, now the poet is trying to say that think of com, tom and bomb. Okay, com, tom and bomb are rhyming words. They have same sounds, but D-O-L-L, doll, and R-O-L-L, roll. Students, you can see O-L-L, O-L-L both in these letters. But when we pronunciate it, the sound of these words came differently. Okay, when we pronunciate com, tom and bomb, O-M-B, you can see in both these words, but they are rhyming words, but O-L-L and O-L-L, you can see these letters in both these words, but the sound comes differently. Since P is rhymed with say, when we pronunciate P and say, okay, when we pronunciate P and say, the sound of these two words is same. Okay, so these are rhyming words. These are in present tense, but when they are changed into past tense, pay becomes paid and say becomes said. Students, you can see the changes. Aap is change ko dekh sakte hain. When pay and say in dono ki same sound hai, then these are rhyming words. Okay, jab humne ise past tense mein convert kiya, the past tense of pay is paid and the past tense of say is said. Okay, paid and said both are different in sound. Now next one is, think of blood, food and good. Mood is not pronounced like could. Wherefore done, but gone and lone, is there any reason known? Okay, so you can see blood, food and good. Students, you can see any same sound in these three words? No. So these are not rhyming words. Mood is also not pronounced like could. Wherefore done, gone and lone. Done, D-O-N-E. O-N-E is, you can see O-N-E in both, in these three words. Okay, but when we pronunciate it, the sound comes differently. Is there any reason? What is the reason behind of it? Kya reason hai iska? To sum up all, it seems to me sounds and letters don't agree. The reason of all these is that, to sum up all, it seems to me sound and letters don't agree to each other. Okay, किसी भी लैंग्वेज में, यानी इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज में साउंड्स और लेटर्स जो है वो एक दूसरे से एग्री नहीं करते हैं. ओके, दे डोंट डिपेंड ईच अदर, दे आर इनडिपेंडेंट. ओके, वो दोनों एक दूसरे से आज़ाद हैं. साउंड्स एंड लेटर्स डोंट एग्री टू ईच अदर. ओके, दैट इज फॉर टूडेज ट्रेंड्स. इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो लेक्चर वी विल discuss about the exercise of this poem. Till then, you will revise this poem at your home and learn it heartily. Goodbye, students.